In a male-dominated competition, Hilal came forward and defended her opinion by saying that it is extremism that sees her and her talent for literature as being at odds with religion, rather than proper Islamic beliefs. So, what do proper Islamic beliefs say about women? This leads me to read a passage from a publication titled Reconciling Islam with Feminism by Iman Hashim. Feminists have tended to regard religion as just another of the sources of women's subordination, citing the manner in which women are often represented as subordinated in religious texts, and the frequency with which religion is used to justify and maintain men's dominant positions in society. Although these charges are leveled at all the major religions, Islam in particular has a reputation for being anti-woman and for supporting a segregated social system where men are economically and politically marginalized. Many Muslim women and men disagree with such a view. Now, when we think of Islamic feminism, there are considerations that it is paradoxical and oxymoronic. Still and all, Islamic feminism speaks on behalf of women who don't want to choose between secular or Western feminist emancipation and their belonging to Islam as a culture and religion. They position themselves as Muslim women who are not blind to or passive towards patriarchy, but instead, they aim to produce an alternative to secular feminism